Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss implicit differentiation. Before we begin, you should know what is implicit function. Functions can be divided into two parts, explicit function, implicit function. What is explicit function? If y is given in terms of x or x is given in terms of y, in this example, x is given in terms of y or y is given in terms of x. So they all are explicit function, means if one of the variable can be expressed as in terms of other variable, then the function is called explicit function. We have studied so far how to differentiate these functions. Now let's discuss what is implicit function. See this example, x square plus y square is equal to 2xy, neither x is solved in terms of y nor y is solved in terms of x. See this example, in all these examples, x and y are not solved or cannot be solved, but a relation in x and y are given. Such functions are called implicit functions, or such equations are called implicit equations. We have to learn how to differentiate these implicit functions. So let's get started. Let's start on the first example. The question is, find dy by dx if y plus sine y is equals to cos x. This is an implicit function because x and y are expressed by a relation, but neither x is given nor y is given, though we can find the value of x if we want, but it is an explicit function and we have to find dy by dx. Like other types of differentiation, we have to find here also dy by dx. How to find dy by dx in implicit functions because y is not given? So the procedure is very simple. We have to, whatever relation implicit function is given, the first step is differentiate with respect to x. We have to differentiate given relation with respect to x. So what is y's derivative? It is dy by dx plus sine y's derivative. As we have discussed in our previous video, if you have to differentiate sine u with respect to x, so it will be cos u into du by dx. Means u is the function of other variable and we are differentiating with respect to x. So it would be sin u's derivative would be cos u into du by dx, means its differentiation would be multiplied. This will work here also because here y is given and we are differentiating with respect to x. So sin y's differentiation is cos y into dy by dx is equal to, what is cos x differentiation with respect to x? It is negative of sin x. So we have differentiated the function, but we have to find dy by dx. So just recollect all the terms which are having dy by dx. So we can see that two terms are having dy by dx. So take out dy by dx as a common multiple. So dy by dx take out 1. If we will take dy by dx common, what will be left out? 1 plus. What will be left out here? Cos y is equals to negative of sin x. So finally, from here we can say that dy by dx is equal to negative of sin x divided by this. So finally, the value of dy by dx is minus sin x upon 1 plus cos y. Point to be noted, in implicit function, dy by dx is mixed form of x and y. Means when we get dy by dx in implicit functions, we get dy by dx easily, but it is mixed forms in x and y, both the variables. NCERT exercise 5.3. First question is 2x plus 3y equals to sin x, find dy by dx. In all the questions, you have to find dy by dx only. First of all, differentiating with respect to x. So whatever the relation is, just you differentiate with respect to x. So So 2, what is x differentiation? 1. And 3, constant will be as it is. What is derivative of y? Dy by dx. Sin x derivative is cos x. 2 plus 3 dy by dx is equal to cos x. And we have to find dy by dx. So 3 dy by dx is equal to cos x minus 2. So finally, dy by dx is equal to cos x minus 2 by 3. This is dy by dx in this particular question. Do not find any variable but differentiate with respect to x and get the value of dy by dx. Third question is ax plus by square is equals to cos y. This question is given. So what is the first step? Differentiating with respect to x. A being constant will be as it is, differentiation of x is 1, b will be as it is, y square's differentiation. But y square's differentiation is not 2y, it is 2y into dy by dx. You have to remember this always, that y square's derivative is 2y into dy by dx. So b, y square's derivative is 2y into dy by dx. In same way, what is derivative of cos y? Derivative of cos y is negative of sin y into dy by dx. After differentiation, that is after first line, you have to write all the terms having dy by dx in one side. So obviously, this 2y b 2by into dy by dx, this term is having dy by dx, and just bring this negative sign y there, so it would be like this, and a would be transferred there, because means where dy by dx is not there, we will send in other side. This is the main procedure. Dy by dx taking out, 2by plus sin y is equal to negative of a. And finally, which we have to find in this question is dy by dx is equal to negative of a by 2by plus sin y. So, dy by dx is equal to negative of a upon 2by plus sin y. This is the value of dy by dx. This is first question, 5.3. Third question. Let's move to the fourth question of 5.3. Question is xy plus y square is equals to 10x plus y. Find the value of dy by dx. As usual, the first line will be same, differentiating with respect to x. Okay, start differentiating. So in this question, both the side would be differentiated. So let's write dy by dx. If we directly differentiate, then also it's okay, but let's write d by dx means we are differentiating both the side. Here, as two functions of x are present over here, two functions, so uv rule we have to apply. So let's apply uv rule. What is the product rule of differentiation? First function, differentiation of second, plus second function, differentiation of first. So x differentiation 1, and y square's derivative, as we have discussed, 2y dy by dx is equal to 10x differentiation is sec a square x plus y's derivative is dy by dx only. And just like previous questions, all the terms which are having dy by dx, get them in one side. So yes, 1, 2, 3, three terms are having dy by dx. So let them transfer or let them keep in one side. So this would be negative because it is in RHS. Okay, Now the terms which are not having dy by dx will be sent other side. So it would be negative. Sec square x is already there and y we have sent there. Now take common dy by dx. So it would be x plus 2y minus 1 is equal to sec square x minus y dy by dy by dx is equal to this sec square x minus y divided by x plus 2y minus 1. So this is dy by dx. That is how to find differentiation of implicit functions. So let's see sixth question, which is x cube plus x square y plus xy square plus y cube equals to 81. Find the value of dy by dx. So the first step is same, differentiating with respect to x. We will differentiate with respect to x both the sides. So d by dx of x cube plus d by dx of this x square y plus d by dx of xy square plus d by dx of y cube is equal to d by dx of 81, which is 0, because d by dx constant terms differentiation is 0. We have already discussed these all things. Okay, so let's differentiate x cube. 3x square plus this x square y is the product of two functions, first and second. So we have to apply here product rule. First function, differentiation of y, which is dy by dx plus y, and derivative of x square, which is 2x plus. Again here x into y square, product of two functions are there. So we have to apply here again product rule. X y square's derivative is 2y dy by dx plus y square, and derivative of x is 1. Okay. Y cube's derivative is 3y square into dy by dx is equal to 0. All the terms which are having dy by dx will be sent one side. Okay. So x square dy by dx, this term is having dy by dx. 2xy dy by dx plus 3y square dy by dx, and other terms which are free from dy by dx will be sent one side, other side. Okay, so this 3x square will be sent there, so negative of 3x square. 2xy will be sent there, so negative of 2xy. Negative of y square, that's it. Only three terms are free from dy by dx. So as we used to do in this method, taking out dy by dx. So x square plus 2xy plus 3y square is equal to negative of 3x square plus 2xy plus y square. So finally, dy by dx in this question is negative 3x square plus 2xy plus y square by x square plus 2xy plus 3y square. Hopefully, you understood the method of implicit differentiation, how to differentiate an implicit function. I think you understood. So dear students, NCERT book miscellaneous exercise 15 question. This is very important question from exam point of view. 15 question is, one implicit function is given, x minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square is equal to c square, where c is positive. Then prove that this is a constant independent of a and b. Means our implicit function is given, from this implicit function we have to find dy by dx, and then from dy by dx we have to find double derivative. What is this double derivative? Means suppose dy by dx for any, suppose y is equal to x square, so dy by dx is 2x, and if one more time you differentiate this function, this is called double derivative. So again you differentiate, then x would be 1 and 2. So for any function, double derivative can be determined. So double derivative means this. So in this question, if this implicit function is given, first you find dy by dx, then you find second derivative, put the value in this and prove that it is a constant free from a and b. That's it. Okay, so let's start this question. I have to write differentiating with respect to x, d by dx of x minus a whole square plus d by dx of y minus b whole square is equal to d by dx of c square. Okay, x minus a whole square differentiation. So as we have already discussed chain rule, so you can differentiate function of function, means x minus a whole square's derivative is 2 times x minus a into x minus a's derivative is 1 only, plus 2 times y minus b, and y minus b's derivative is dy by dx. As c is constant, so its differentiation would be 0. The first motive is to find dy by dx. So 2y minus b dy by dx is equal to, this term we have to send there. So negative of 2 x minus a, 2 cancel. So dy by dx is equal to negative x minus a upon y minus b. So this is dy by dx we can be used first equation. Okay, now but the question is find something like the, one expression is there in which we have to put double differentiation. So we will write again differentiating with respect to x. We have to differentiate one more time this function. So let's differentiate one more time. Whenever we differentiate one more time, we write this d2y by dx2 is equal to, now in order to differentiate d by dx of this whole term, negative of x minus a upon y minus b, we have to differentiate numerator upon denominator. So we can write d2y by dx2 is equal to negative sign out, and just apply the quotient rule. What is the quotient rule of differentiation? Denominator square, denominator and differentiation of numerator minus numerator and differentiation of denominator. So just I have used the quotient rule of differentiation. So the second derivative is, be careful, y minus b whole square, negative sign outside. Now just put the value of differentiation of x minus a is 1 only, and differentiation of y minus b is nothing but dy by dx. In this step, this is very important step, because in this step you have to put the value of dy by dx which we have written in first equation, because we have already got dy by dx. So here you have to put, so double differentiation is negative y minus b minus x minus a, and dy by dx is this. Be careful, this is already negative, so this term would be positive, x minus a by y minus b upon y minus b whole square. Okay, so now this would be simplified डी स्क्वायर वाई बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू नेगेटिव साइन ऑलरेडी आउट. ओके वाई माइनस बी एल सी एम एंड दिस वन मोर वाई माइनस बी इज देयर सो दे बोथ विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड विद ईच अदर एंड दिस वाई माइनस बी विल मल्टीप्लाई हियर वाई माइनस बी होल स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स माइनस ए हेक्स माइनस ए विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड विद ईच अदर. सो वी गॉट दिस टर्म. ओके नाउ यू टेल मी इन दिस क्वेश्चन वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई माइनस बी होल स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स माइनस ए होल स्क्वायर. इन दिस क्वेश्चन इन बिगिनिंग इट इज गिवन द गिवन क्वेश्चन इज एक्स माइनस ए होल स्क्वायर प्लस वाई माइनस बी होल स्क्वायर इक्वल टू सी स्क्वायर. सो पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ सी स्क्वायर हियर सो इट वुड बी नेगेटिव सी स्क्वायर अपॉन वाई माइनस बी y minus b 1 power, y minus b 2 power. So it would be 3 power of y minus b. So now this is the second equation. This is second equation which we have to use. In this question, what is to prove? 1 plus dy by dx whole square to the power 3 by 2 by double differentiation. So we have to put both the values in this form. So let's put the values. 1 plus what is dy by dx we got dy by dx negative x minus a upon y minus b. Okay, to the power 3 by 2 upon double differentiation. So our double differentiation is negative of c square by y minus b whole cube. So let's simplify it. 1 plus it's a square, so it would be positive, no? So y minus b, when we simplify it, it would be y minus b whole square plus x minus a whole square by y minus b whole square, but whole power 3 by 2. The whole power 3 by 2 and upon this, so it can be reversed and it can be written y minus b cube by c square. So see here, this is again c square power 3 by 2, so actually it is c cube. So when we simplify it, y minus b whole square, this is c square, and c square to the power 3 by 2, this is about numerator, and in denominator y minus b whole square to the power 3 by 2, because both are having 3 by 2 power, 3 by 2 both numerator and denominator both, and y minus b cube by c square is in second term. So when we simplify this power, so it would be c cube by y minus b cube, because 2 cancelled, and this is y minus b cube by c square. So this power, the whole power, whole term cancelled, c cube by c square is nothing but C only. So this we are getting, this whole expression is C. It means what we have to prove in this question? Prove that this is constant independent of A and B. So it's proved that this term is constant and independent of A and B. So this was the important question and not that easy. So that is differentiation of implicit function, NCERT exercise 5.3 and important question of miscellaneous exercise we have seen. I hope this is useful for you.